Hi guys, thank you for watching and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I am super excited because as you can tell, I have a brand new background and I also upgraded to a few more angles with different cameras so I could get you guys more details and I could show you guys more of the process. And I am super, super happy that I can finally bring this to you guys. It is a project that took me about 6 months and I am super excited that it is finally ready for you guys to see. I decided to do a video on how to do nails for beginners because it is a highly requested video and I wanted to wait until I had all my angles ready so you guys could see more of the process. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and without further ado, let's get started. I am going to be working on my natural nails. I think it's a lot easier for me to explain to you guys while I work on my nails. And also, I went ahead and soaked off everything that was previously on my nails. I don't have any acrylics or anything, so I could show you guys from scratch how to do this process. And also, they look a little dry right now because I soaked them in 100% acetone, and acetone is a little drying. The first thing that you need to do is go ahead and have your client wash their hands and remove any contaminants and oils that there may be on the hands. And you could also use hand sanitizer, it's really a preference, but if there's a lot of lotion or any kind of oils, I would recommend that you guys have your clients wash their hands first. Moving on, I am going to be using my e-file to remove the natural shine from the nails. So I'm going to work at the lowest speed possible, and I'm gonna start with the pinky. So again, very gentle, because we are just removing the shine. It is not to remove any of the nail plates or bring it down. It is actually to just remove the shine from the natural nails so the product attaches to the nails. The sanding band also works for removing the dead cuticle. So it's kind of like killing two birds with one stone. Whether you're removing the shine from the natural nail or you are filing the nails, you need to pull the skin back just so you don't hurt the client when you get closer to the cuticle area. That area is extremely sensitive and very prone to bleeding if you guys hit it too hard. Make sure that when you guys are filing, you don't stay on one spot because the friction of the e-file on the nail may cause a burning sensation and it is very uncomfortable. I am going to do the last nail using a hand file so you guys can see the difference between using a hand file and the e-file when it comes to removing the natural shine from the nail. So I am going to use a hand file that has a grit of 120 on one side and 80 on the other. However, I am just going to be focusing with the side that's 120 grit. So again, you want to pull the skin back and gently remove the shine from the natural nail. You guys really want to get in those corners because that's where lifting usually occurs. and really close to the cuticle area, so you guys remove any type of skin, cuticle, anything that there may be that could cause any type of lifting. After removing the shine from the natural nails, I am going to remove all the dust so I can go ahead and apply tips. You guys could also use sculpting forms to lengthen the nail, but it is a little bit harder to use than tips. So I would suggest you guys start with tips first and then move on to using forms. I forgot to mention that when you guys are prepping the natural nail, you want to push the cuticles back, especially if they're grown out, because that is going to cause lifting. If you need to remove them using nippers, you can just be extremely careful because nippers are very dangerous, especially if you get way too close to the cuticle area. Moving on, I am going to be applying tips. I've had this case for a while now. It has been with me for a few years now. And I am just going to make sure that the tips fit from side to side. So what you would do is you would measure from one side to the other and push down. If it fits, then you are using the right tip. So I'm gonna put this one on the side and I'm gonna continue with the rest of my nails. A lot of times the ring fingernail and the index fingernail have the same size tips. It varies from person to person, but usually that is the case. So I'm going to measure out this one. And as you can see, it's a little bit too big. It goes outside of my nail. So I am going to use a number 4. And as you can tell, it fits perfectly from one side to the other. I am going to try the same number on the index to see if it fits. Just a little bit bigger, so I'm going to downsize to a number 5. And that fits perfectly. And for the middle finger, I'm going to use a number 3. And for my pinky, I would say maybe a number 7. And that fits way too big, actually. So I'm gonna try a number 8. And that's perfect. When you're working with tips, the smaller the number, the bigger the tip. So it can be a little bit confusing at first, but I'm pretty sure you guys will get the hang of it. After picking out the tips, I usually organize them, starting with the thumb, index, middle, ring, and pinky, just so I know exactly where to place them. To put them on the nail, I am going to use a nail glue, and I'm actually using the base from the dipping powders of Kiara Sky because it actually acts as a nail glue as well. So I'm gonna open it. And if it's stuck, usually nail glue gets stuck, so just move it from side to side and it breaks it loose. I'm gonna start with the pinky. I'm gonna grab just a little bit, remove the excess from one side of the brush and go from one side to the other. I don't wanna put too much glue on the nail because it will make it really messy, and also it is going to take forever for it to actually adhere to the nail. So I'm just going to firmly press it down and wait a few seconds until it dries. I will be repeating the same process to all the nails. When you're applying tips, you want to apply them close to the free edge. You don't want to apply them way too close to the cuticle area because that is not going to give you enough strength. The nails are actually going to come off very soon. So as close to the free edge as you can is where you should always place your tip because the acrylic should be attaching to the natural nail as much as possible. If there are any spaces between the natural nail and the tip, you can actually apply a little bit of brush and nail glue right on top and it gets rid of that empty gap. After applying the tips, I let the glue dry 100% and I proceed to removing the excess tip, and I am going to leave them at about a medium length just so you guys could appreciate the details of the application a little more. So for that, I am going to be using a nail cutter and I am going to kind of like eye it and just take it from there. Kind of like compare them so you could see they're about the same length. There is no way of actually measuring the nails and telling if one is longer than the other just by like a millimeter or something like that. You have to kind of eye it and learn how to cut them so they look even. So I am just going to start with the pinky. And I'm going to do right about this length. So again, I'm just eyeing it and kind of wanting to do the same thing on the other nails. So let's say right about there. It doesn't have to be 100% perfect right now. I mean, it has to be as close as you can to perfect, but if you made a little mistake, you could use a form to lengthen the nail, or you could use a hand file or an e-file to bring the length down if any of the nails are longer than the rest. After removing the excess tip, the easiest way for you guys to achieve the shape that you are wanting to get is to remove the excess of the tip right now before applying any acrylic or any gel on top of it, because it is going to actually be harder for you guys to shape if there's acrylic, especially if you don't count with an e-file. So I am going to shape them into square since it is the basic shape, and so you guys can learn. And then after this video, we can learn a little more about different shapes. So again, I am going to use the same file, but I am going to use the 80 grit side. And I am just going to push the skin back with the file, go from under and then kind of like going in at an angle and just filing straight. I am keeping my hand super firm just so I don't file it into another shape by mistake. So again, from under and just rotate the file at an angle to get the shape. And it doesn't have to be perfect, it just has to be good enough so your application is a lot easier. I'm going to use this thing to rest my hand and complete the filing. one's just a tad bit longer than the pinky, so I'm going to bring the length down just a little bit with my hand file. You don't have to press really hard, especially if you guys are using a good file, because the file does all the work, and since the nail is very thin, I mean the extension is very thin, it is super easy for you guys to file. This one's also a tad bit longer, so I am going to bring it down. This one just a tiny bit. After completing the application of tips and also the filing, I am going to blend them to the natural nail using the same e-file sanding band that I used previously to remove the shine from the natural nails. So again, at the lowest speed possible, I will be focusing on the separation line between the nail and the extension. When you guys are applying acrylic, there is really no need to remove the shine from the extension because acrylic naturally adheres to plastic. So I am just working on the natural nail and just that separation line so it looks really blended and it looks like the natural nail. So after completing that part of the process, I am going to be removing the dust using the same fluffy brush that I was using previously. Now to prep the nail, I am going to be using the dehydrator and also primer. I start with the dehydrator and I am using Bonded by OPI. You don't really have to use the same line of products as long as they are quality products, because all the companies say that you have to pretty much stick to their monomer and, you know, their primer and all of the above. But you can mix high quality products as long as they are high quality. At least that's what I've learned from my experience. I know that if you go to nail school, they're going to tell you otherwise, but this is just my own personal experience. I have mixed a bunch of products and I never had a problem, as long as they are quality products. Okay, so I am just applying the dehydrator on the natural nail. Again, no need to prep the tip because the acrylic is going to bond to it naturally. Now I am going in with my primer. I am using C&D Nail Prime. This is the acid-free primer, so if it runs a little bit to the cuticle, there is no danger of the cuticle burning or anything like that. So this one, I am just going to remove the excess. I don't want to oversaturate the nail because if you put too much primer on the nail is going to lift. After completing the preparation process, you don't need to have your clients wash their hands or anything, and actually water penetrates anything because the nail, as of right now, the nail is so porous, so it's absorbing everything you're putting on it. So don't use any hand sanitizer, any water, anything like that, because it is going to make the nail lift. Make sure you just apply the acrylic. After the acrylic has been applied, then you can wash your hands and do everything that you want to do, including using oils. Okay, so for the acrylic application, I am going to use the dish for the monomer, which is the purple liquid. Sometimes they come in clear liquid. I am actually using Entity's monomer, but I buy the gallons, so I like to put them in small containers so it's easier for me to use them. And I am going to use Harmony's Studio Cover Cool Pink. This is a very natural color and it's very easy to apply. A lot of products are hard to apply because they have a different formula to them, and you just have to play with the products and kind of find out which ones need more powder and which ones need more monomer. So what I'm gonna do, I'm actually filling this up, this glass container, with monomer. Going to close it because monomer evaporates. So I'm going to close it and put it right here. And then I am going to use a number 10 German Kolinsky brush. I like to use them flat just so I can have a better application. It is super hard for me to apply with pointed brushes. It is a personal preference, so I am going to use a flat brush or crimped. So to remove the bubbles from the brush, what I'm going to do is I am going to sink the brush in the monomer and press down. This is going to prevent any type of air bubbles in your product and in the finish of your nails. So you can see, all the bubbles are floating to the top of the monomer, and it is going to give you a better bead also when you pick it up using your monomer and your polymer. I'm going to use a sheet of paper towel, and I'm going to fold it just so it can soak more product, meaning monomer. And now I am ready to apply. So I'm going to use this as support, and I'm going to start with the pinky. So I'm going to dip it, remove the excess, and I'm going to go into my polymer and drag it. Some people like to let it sit, but I love the way this bead comes out. I'm going to place it in the middle of the nail, remove the monomer excess from my brush on the napkin, and then I'm going to start pushing back towards the cuticle area. I'm going to start with the middle fingernail so I could show you guys, since it's a little bit of a bigger nail and it is more focused in the middle of the camera. So what you're going to do is you're going to dip your brush into the monomer all the way down. You're going to remove the excess on the side of the dish or the container you're using for the monomer. As you can tell, my brush is saturated with monomer, but not super saturated with monomer. So I am just going to sink it in the polymer, drag it in, and that's a perfect bead. I am going to quickly place it in the middle of the nail, clean my brush, grab a little bit more of monomer, and push it towards the cuticle area as quickly as possible, because working with acrylic is working against the clock. It's super fast drying, so you want to work as fast as you can so you can mold the acrylic to the nail. If you need to, you can use the belly of the brush, meaning this part of the brush, to press the product down. And you don't have to use just one bead. You could use more than one bead if you need to. Also, it depends on what kind of brush that you're using. The bigger the brush, the bigger the piece that you can pick up. Or the bigger the bead, I should say. So now I am just applying on the free edge, removing the excess monomer from my brush. And now I am going to start dragging it softly towards the cuticle area, making sure I take care of the sidewalls as well. I'm going to grab another bead and I'm going to apply it on the center of the nail. This time I am not going to remove the excess monomer. I am just going to push it down, or push it up, I mean, to the cuticle area. And now that I molded it, I am going to start dragging it towards the free edge. I am working with really small beads for these nails, actually. So it's taking me a little longer than it should. But I just wanted to kind of break it down for you guys so you can see that you can do this process at first with a bunch of beads, and then as you get better and you become faster, then you can use a bigger brush and grab bigger pieces or bigger beads of acrylic and work with them. It is a matter of time to learn the proper application of acrylic. So as you can see, I am shaping the sidewalls. And don't worry too much about this side of the nail. That's all extra. And that is going to be removed later on during the filing process. So again, another bead working towards the cuticle area. And now I am going to give this nail a nice apex, which means the stress point has to be on point or else the nail will break. I am very gently dragging the acrylic. I am not pressing too hard, and if you notice, I am not pressing with the tip of the brush because that is just going to puncture the product and remove the product from the nail. So I am very gentle as I am moving the acrylic. So I'm gonna remove the extra monomer from my brush and start blending it. So as you can see, there's a beautiful apex there. There's a beautiful curve, and that is your stress point. You don't want to keep that fragile because the nail can crack in the middle, and that is very painful. So make sure you have a nice apex. It doesn't have to be extremely exaggerated, but there has to be an apex. I am going to use another brush just so I could show you guys how to use it. And this is a number 14 brush. It is also a German Kolinsky, and I am going to repeat the same process, but you guys are going to be able to see that this kind of brushes pick up a bigger bead. Therefore, you don't have to apply as many beads. Oops. Okay, that was too much monomer. So again, just sink it in the product and the monomer, swipe it on the side, saturate it, sink it, drag it, and there is a bigger bead. Now I'm quickly working with it because acrylic dries very fast. So as you can see, this pretty much covered the whole nail. I just have to work on my apex, but you don't have to pick up as many beads as you have to do it with a smaller brush. So again, it is just a preference, but I wanted to show you guys the two sides of the spectrum so you guys get to see what it's like to work with each brush. So I'm just going to separate it. Make sure the acrylic doesn't touch the skin, because if it does, it's going to lift. So I'm just going to grab another bead, place it on the middle of the nail. And again, start working with it. If you need to grab a little bit more of monomer, feel free to do so. And start blending it, blending it, blending it until you have that beautiful apex. So now I am just going to proceed to completing the same process to all the nails, and I am going to finish this nail using my number 14 brush since it is a faster application for me. After completing the application process, I am going to let the acrylic dry 100% and then I'm going to proceed to filing. I am going to use a fine carbide bit and also an 80 grit hand file to shape the nails and also to remove any of the rough edges. And the carbide bit is just to remove any excess acrylic. The way to tell if the acrylic is completely dry is to tap it, and if it makes that tapping noise, that means it's ready to file. So the thumb is not, but the rest are. I'm going to file at about medium speed. You don't want to go too fast because the friction is going to burn the client's nail. So I'm just going to remove the excess from the underneath of the nail. I am pressing very firmly and I am using my pinky as support. At a 45 degree angle with the carbide bit, I am going to remove the excess from the cuticle area. and I'm moving in one direction just so I don't cut myself. As I start getting closer to the apex, I want to use the middle of this carbide bit. And as I get closer to the tip, I want to use the end of the carbide bit. Just pretty much follow the shape of the nail and make sure you pull the skin back so you don't cut yourself or your client. And very gently remove any excess from the underneath of the nail. I like to check nails in different angles just to make sure they're even, that there aren't any type of bumps. And I like to blend the cuticle area really well just so when it grows out, it doesn't look like there's a fake nail on top of your real nail. Okay, so I like to look at nails from this angle to make sure that it's even. So what I do is I take my file and I shape it this way. That way I know 100% that it's even and that the shape looks amazing. I'm applying the same technique I applied earlier. I am starting from the bottom of the nail, pulling the skin back, and then rotating my file at an angle just so I can remove all the excess from the sides. Don't forget about your sidewalls. And I'm going to repeat the same process to all the nails. After completing all the filing process, I am going to remove the extra dust with the same fluffy brush I used previously. At this point, you can buff them if you'd like to. The carbide bit that I use is fine, so it leaves a very smooth finish. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna spray 99% alcohol to get rid of any dust or contaminants that there may be on the nail. And I'm just gonna wipe them. And I like to use a cotton piece and a little bit of acetone and remove any monomer or any acrylic that there may be on the skin. After that's completed, I like to go back again with 99% alcohol and a little bit of paper towel. I like to use paper towel instead of lint-free wipes because I feel like even though they say they're lint-free, they're not really lint-free. So I like to use the paper towel instead. And last but not least, I like to apply a gel top coat to top it off. And I am going to cure this under an LED lamp for 60 seconds. I'm going to cure for 60 seconds. Okay, and after curing the nails, I am going to apply a little bit of cuticle oil. Okay guys, so this is the final product. I am super happy with these nails. I really hope you found this video educational and that it helps you out a lot for those of you who are beginning in the nail industry. And if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up, share, subscribe, and don't forget to let me know in the comments down below what you would like to see next. And also, let's look at the final product pictures. I'll see you guys next time. Mwah.